Greetings, folks. Joseph Kursky here with you to talk about a wonderful new digital book, Lindsey the GIS Specialist, a GIS mapping story. Bolton and Mink were the creators of this book, and I salute them. They are engineers, hydrologists, designers, GIS specialists, geographic information systems specialists, but they've developed this wonderfully approachable way of you talking to your special young person in your life. So it's pitched as a children's book, but you can also talk to your mom, to your colleagues that don't know anything about geographic information systems, what it is and why it actually is important and why it matters. So I also salute Tyler Danielson, GIS specialist, for authoring the book, and Lime Valley Advertising for illustrations. They're just wonderful illustrations. I'm not going to give it all away, but let's get into it a little bit. Lindsey, the GIS specialist, Bolton and Mink. So Lindsey is a very engaging character. Hey, my name is Lindsey and I'm a GIS specialist. And I love this bird that goes through all these pages. GIS stands for Geographic Information Systems. And here's what I love about this page. I make maps and I analyze spatial data. So to me, like in all of these videos of mine, I'm always talking about don't just put your points on a map and call it done and then walk away and saying, isn't this great? No, it's all about analysis. It's all about making sense of the world from local to global scale. So that's another reason why I love this book. And they get right to the heart of the matter. Data. You need data to make maps. Now, in the Spatial Reserves data book and blog that my colleague Jill Clark and I wrote the book, and we write the blog weekly about, it's all about crowdsourcing and copyright and data quality and data sources and the open data movement and data standards. Actually, data is at the heart of what many of us do with GIS. Indeed, GIS was big data before big data was a term. We've always been about using data in thoughtful, scientific, rigorous ways and assessing the quality of it as we go. So I love that about this book. Also, on this right side here, you can see that Lindsey talks about, hey, when making a map, I collect my own data sometimes, and other times I get it from a trusted source. So how do you trust the sources? Again, that's what our Spatial Reserves data blog is all about. This is just an example of the wonderful illustrations in this book. You've got an oblique bird's eye view of the terrain and talks about the different data types. Like, different data types could be a very boring, dry subject, right? Many of us are instructors and we've had various ways that we've talked about these concepts, but I just love the way that this book brings this to life and makes it fun and exciting. So the book is, I'm not going to give it all away, but the book is laden with UAVs, GPS, and actually doing something that looks at patterns, relationships, and trends and solving problems, making sense of spatial patterns in our world to make a better world. That's exactly why pretty much all of us in GIS are in the field, because we want to make a more healthier, more sustainable, happier future. So that's exactly what this book touches on. Let's skip to the end. Bolton and Mink, Lindsey the GIS Specialist. I highly, highly recommend it. I salute everyone who is involved in creating it, and I'm definitely going to promote it. Go check it out, folks, at this URL. Thanks, and map on.